that is the yatra which is being continued by Dipinder Hooda, and today he has reached at Ambala. We will talk to him. So sir, you have been conducting this yatra for last so many days. We have seen so many times, even during the rain also you were continuing this yatra. What type of feedback are you getting from the people of Haryana?
See, in total we have covered 49 constituencies, and the feedback, in fact this was the 50th constituency. So we have covered 49 constituencies, this was 49th constituency, and the feedback has been exceptional. People of Haryana are in mood for a change. 10 years of misgovernance on part of the BJP has left Haryana nowhere. Haryana today ranks number one in terms of unemployment, in terms of inflation, number one in drug use, number one in the whole nation as far as crime is concerned, crime rate as per Government of India. So these stats, these are not merely statistics. A state like Haryana, when it's, you know, top of, you know, the list of all the states in terms of unemployment, inflation, crime rate, drugs, that means the government, 10 years of BJP rule has completely failed the people. Sir, and no, that's why people want a change.
No election date has already been announced. We have seen the multiple transfer had been done, and the Congress has already lodged a complaint. Do you think that is they are trying to gain political mileage by transferring all?
See, completely unheard of what they are resorting to. After the dates have been announced, they want to bring about these transfers. That needs to be, this is just shows desperation on part of the BJP. In fact, this also shows that I think the state government was not consulted by the, either they did not know that Election Commission is going to take this step. So somehow there is lack of confidence between the state government and the center government and the Election Commission, the whole process, because the Chief Minister was in the morning saying absolutely no chance elections are going to be held in time, and they were preparing for a cabinet meeting. In fact, some of the announcements that they made, those announcements have not been even notified.
For example, they have sent to the Election Commission. They are saying we have sent to the Election Commission. Do you think that
those announcements were not meant to be sent to Election Commission? Those announcements should have been providing relief to the people. For example, they said 500 rupees per cylinder. Now they did not even implement it, and before their implementation, the code of conduct has been announced. So I think the BJP realizes that people are upset with the BJP. That's why they started making these announcements. But they then realized that none of these announcements can translate on the ground. So that is why they preponed the election.
So, sir, one question. Lot of political activities going on. JJP had four of the MLA. They had already resigned from the BJP. JJP. But we have seen even during the Lok Sabha election, lot of independent they had given a support. And what we have learned, three JJP netas, they are going to join Congress. Do you think that is the air which is telling how the people and how these even leaders, they are trying to
absolutely
change the shape?
If you look at last 2 years, more than 45 ex-ministers, ex-MPs, one sitting MP, many sitting MLAs have joined the Congress party, leaving the BJP or the JJP. That just shows you where the mood of the people as far as Haryana is concerned.